Hello friends, welcome to another video lecture of machine design. And today we are going to see how machine elements are designed when they are subjected to fluctuating load. We are going to see all the design process and we will also solve some numericals based on those design process. We have recently started machine design. We have completed one chapter already, designed against static load. And this is the second chapter, design against fluctuating load. So don't miss any video lecture of machine design. Every day at 7:30 p.m. from Monday to Saturday, I will be live in front of you teaching machine design and we are going to cover the entire syllabus. So please go and subscribe this channel. If you don't want to miss any video lecture of mine, please go and subscribe right now. And my friends, on this journey, you have to support me. Because if you support me, then I will cover as many topics as possible. I will try to solve as many numericals as possible. So for that, I need your support. So please, first, like this video right now. Like this video right now. Hit the like button right now, my friend. I told you, it is like a virtual attendance. So if you are present, mark your presence by hitting the like button. And the second thing you need to do is, share this video, my friend. Share the link of this video. If you can't share it everywhere, if you can't share it with all your friends, at least share it with three of your friends and ask them to share it with three other friends. Okay, so make this a chain, my friend, so that we will cover the entire nation. We have to reach to as many people as possible. This is free education, my friend. So we need to be a part of this free education. We need to be a part of this revolution. So please, share this video with at least three of your friends. Share the link of this video with at least three of your friends right now, my friend, and ask them to come online and watch this video, my friend. Okay, so this is how you can support me. And if you support me, then I'll go on making this video lectures and I will try to cover as much syllabus as possible. Now, my friend, we don't get a lot of time on YouTube, but on Unacademy Plus, we are available for you. And whatever you are watching here, this is just a trailer. The entire picture, if you want to see, you have to subscribe to Unacademy Plus, my friend. Unacademy Plus is India's number one learning platform. And we want you to be a part of that platform, my friend. We want you to watch the videos on Unacademy Plus. We want you to be a part of the lecture of Unacademy Plus. And you will feel the difference, my friend. Here, whatever we are teaching on YouTube, we are restricted. There are a lot of restrictions, my friend. But on Unacademy Plus, there is no restriction. That platform is specially designed for online learning. YouTube is not especially designed for online learning. This is just a platform where we can upload the videos. But on Unacademy Plus, we have some specially designed tools for you so that you will feel like you are sitting in a classroom, my friend. You can talk to your lecturer. You can post your doubts, my friend. So there will be amazing tools available on Unacademy Plus. So please go and subscribe to Unacademy Plus, my friends. A lot of students have already subscribed. Every day new students are joining. We have recently started a new batch, my friend. And in a few days, we will launch another batch especially designed for dropout students called Rank Improvement Batch, my friend. Okay, so that batch is specially designed for dropout students, my friend. So please go and subscribe to Unacademy Plus right now. Download the Unacademy Plus app and subscribe to Unacademy Plus. You can take 1 year or 2 year subscription, my friend. It will cost very less compared to the other subscription plans. Okay, so take 1 year or 2 year subscription plan and don't forget to use this code, my friend. Don't forget to use this code APROOP10. You can also find this code in the description of the video. Okay, this is my code. If you apply this code during the payment, you will get a 10% discount. If you apply this code, you'll get a 10% discount, my friend. We covered a few concepts related to fluctuating load. So let's have a quick revision of those concepts. Okay, let's have a quick revision of those concepts and then we will start with a new topic. Okay, so what we covered, my friend, I told you what is a fluctuating stress. Okay, I told you what is a fluctuating stress. So fluctuating stress means it is fluctuating between a minimum and maximum value. It is not constant with respect to time. It is fluctuating between a minimum value and a maximum value. This is sigma minimum and this is sigma maximum, right? So this is fluctuating load, this is fluctuating stress, minimum to maximum, then maximum, right? And this is one cycle, my friend. Minimum to maximum and then again minimum. This is one complete cycle. Okay, this is one complete cycle and this is another one complete cycle. So how many cycles are there? Two cycles. Right now there are two cycles, one and two, my friend. Okay, so this is fluctuating stress, and in order to design the component subjected to fluctuating stress, we need two parameters, my friend. Sigma m, which is called mean stress, which is the average of maximum and minimum. It is nothing but the average of maximum and minimum. Average means center line. It is the center between maximum and minimum. It will be right here. It will be right here, my friend, sigma m. Okay. And the second parameter is stress amplitude. Stress amplitude. What is stress amplitude, my friend? If the center is here, then how much stress is fluctuating above or below the mean stress? Okay, how much it is going above the average or below the average? Okay, so this will be stress amplitude. Okay, this is the mean stress and it is going about this much. Okay, it is going above the sigma m by this much. So this is sigma a, and the equation will be sigma maximum minus sigma minimum divided by 2. So these are the two parameters which are used to design components subjected to fluctuating stress, my friend. Okay, then we saw what is fatigue failure. So what is fatigue failure, my friend? What is fatigue failure? Fatigue failure means, see, static failure means if I apply a load and the stress becomes equal to SYT or SUT, then it will fail, right? If I apply static load and the stress become equal to SYT, means it will fail in yield, and if the stress become equal to SUT, means it will fracture. That is static load. Under static load, there are two failures, yielding and fracture. We have already covered it. Under fluctuating stress, what type of failure take place? Fatigue failure. What is fatigue failure, my friend? Due to repetition of stress, the component will fail. Due to repetition of stress, the component will fail, my friend. So if you are applying a stress and you are repeating it again and again and again, then after some number of cycles, the component will fail, and that is known as fatigue failure. Okay, here sigma maximum will be less than SYT or SUT. Okay, sigma maximum will be less than SYT or SUT, but it will still fail. Why it will fail? Due to repetition. Due to repetition, you are again and again applying the stress. So this sigma max is less than SYT and SUT, but the component will fail due to repetition of stress, and that is known as fatigue failure. Okay, now after this we discussed endurance strength. What is endurance strength, my friend? What is endurance strength? I discussed this graph with you. If you plot a graph between stress and number of cycles, okay, if you plot a graph between, let's say, plus minus sigma, okay, let's say you are applying plus minus sigma and you are plotting a graph between plus minus sigma and number of cycles. Okay, so if the stresses are large, if you are applying large stress, number of cycle will be less. If you keep on reducing the stress, number of cycle will increase, and after a point the cycles become infinite, right? After a point the cycles become infinite. So the stress at which you get infinite cycles, the stress at which you get infinite cycle is known as endurance strength, my friend. Okay, and this graph is for steel. For steel, this graph becomes infinite at 10 to the power 6 cycles, my friend. Okay, so what is endurance strength? Let's say the endurance strength is 200 megapascal. So if you are applying 0 to 200 megapascal, then this component will never fail. Okay, it will sustain infinite cycle. You apply that stress for infinite cycle, it will never fail. But if your stress is above 200, let's say you are applying 300 megapascal, then after some number of cycle, it will fail, my friend. Okay, so 10 to the power 6 cycle means infinite cycle. If it crosses 10 to the power 6 cycle means infinite cycle, it will never fail. Okay, and if it fails before 10 to the power 6 cycle means we will say that it has finite life. Okay, it has finite life. So 10 to the power 6 cycle or more cycle means infinite life. Less than 10 to the power 6 cycle means finite life. Okay, so what is endurance strength? If the stress is less than endurance strength, the component will never fail. But if the stress is more than endurance strength, the component will fail after some number of cycles, my friend. Okay, so this much we have already covered. This is just a quick revision. We have already seen these concepts in detail in the last chapter, in the last lecture. In this lecture, we are going to talk about the design process. Okay, we are going to see how machine element is designed under fluctuating load, my friend. Okay, if you are applying fluctuating load, then how can you find the dimension of machine element? What equation will you use? What procedure will you use to find the dimension? In case of static load, in case of static load, what equations do we use? We use theories of failure. We have 5 theories of failure, 5 equations. So we use those equations to find the dimension, right? But under fluctuating load, what will be the equation? What will be the design process? That we have to see. Now, if you have still not liked the video, please hit the like button right now, my friend. And I told you, you have to share the link with at least 3 of your friends. Okay, at least 3 of your friends, share this link and ask them to share it with other 3 friends. Okay, at least 3 friends, my friend. That's how we will grow. That's how this family will grow. That's how we will make more and more lectures. So please support us in this journey, my friend. Please support us to grow. All right, my friend. Now, where were we? So we were talking about the design process, right? Now, my friend, the design problems related to fluctuating load can be divided into 2 categories. Okay, there are 2 types of design problems. Case 1, when sigma m is 0, and case 2, when sigma m is not 0. Okay, so there are 2 types of problems under fluctuating stress. There are 2 types of condition, there are 2 types of cases. One case is when sigma m is 0, and one case is when sigma m is not 0. Okay, now when the sigma m will be 0? In case of completely reverse stress. In case of completely reverse stress. Okay, like this. Sorry, like this. This is completely reverse stress, my friend. This is completely reverse stress, where the stress fluctuates from minus sigma to plus sigma. Okay, this is minus sigma maximum and this is plus sigma maximum. So minus 100 to plus 100, minus 200 to plus 200, minus 300 to plus 300. If it is fluctuating like that, that means it is completely reverse stress. Understood? So in this case, what will be sigma m? Sigma m will be 0, my friend. Sigma m will be 0. Sigma m is nothing but the center. Sigma m is nothing but the center. So what will be the center of plus sigma max and minus sigma max? 0. So this is the first case. Second case, sigma m is not 0. These type of stresses are known as fluctuating stress. Okay, fluctuating stress. Okay. So this particular stress is completely reverse stress, and except this case, all other stresses will be known as fluctuating stress. Okay. So what will be the example, my friend? This will be the example. Okay. Here, look at this. The center will be somewhere here, right? This is the example. Repeated stress. This is the example. Here, my friend, the mean stress will be somewhere here. And my friend, it can also be like this. It can also be like this. It can also be like this. Some of the stress is tensile and some of it is compressive. Here also mean stress will be somewhere here. So in all 3 cases, my friend, sigma m is not 0. Okay, here the entire stress is tensile. Here also the entire stress is tensile, but minimum is 0. Here some stress is compressive. Look at this. Some stress is compressive. Don't worry. Here also sigma m is not zero. So all these three cases are similar. All these three cases are similar. Their design process is same. And this is a different problem, my friend. Here sigma m is zero. So do you understand difference between these two cases? Do you understand? So for these problems, process is different. For these problems, process is different. Okay, we will study both these problems, but the process will be completely different. Okay, so do you understand this? Case 1 is when sigma m is 0, means completely reverse stress. Case 2 is when sigma m is not 0, means fluctuating stress. Okay, now my friend, these two cases can be further divided. These two cases can be further divided. We can design for infinite life and we can design for finite life. Okay, here also we can design for infinite life and we can also design for finite life. Okay, now what is infinite life, my friend? Number of cycle will be equal to or greater than 10 to the power 6 cycles. Okay, number of cycle will be either equal to 10 to the power 6 or greater than 10 to the power 6. Finite life means less than 10 to the power 6 cycles. Now first we will understand what is infinite life and what is finite life. Okay, let's understand what is infinite life and what is finite life. Okay, let's say, my friend, there is a component, let's say there is a machine element which is subjected to fluctuating load. The load is fluctuating, but in one day the load only fluctuates for 20 cycles. Okay, one day, per day, you are applying the load for 20 cycles. Okay, 20 times it fluctuates, 20 times per day. In one day it fluctuates 20 times. Okay, now let's say you are designing the component, you are designing the machine element for 5 years. Okay, you are designing the machine element for 5 years. So what will be the number of cycles, my friend? What will be the number of cycles? What will be the number of cycles in 5 years? In one day, number of cycle is 20. In one day it fluctuates for 20 cycles. So in 1 year, how many times it will fluctuate? 20 into 365 and in 5 years multiplied by 5. So what will be the number of cycles, my friend? Calculate what will be the number of cycles. 5 into 365 into 20, which is 36,500. Which is 36,500, which is less than 10 to the power 6 cycles, right? 36,500 is less than 10 to the power 6 cycles. Now, my friend, you can see that this component, this particular component is only subjected to 36,500 cycles. So will you design it for infinite life? Will you design it for infinite life? No. Infinite life means the number of cycle will be more than 10 to the power 6 cycle. Okay. But if it is only subjected to this much cycle, then you don't have to save the element for infinite life. You have to save the element for only this much cycles. Okay, you have to save it for only this much cycle. If it can sustain this much cycle, no problem, my friend. If it sustains this much cycle, no problem. So you don't have to design the machine element for infinite life. You only have to design it for 36,500 cycles. So we will design it for finite life. If your number of cycles, required number of cycle, how many number of cycles are required? Okay, if the number of cycles are less than 10 to the power 6, then you will design it for finite life. And if the number of cycles are more than 10 to the power 6, then you will design it for finite life. In both the cases, the criteria is different. In both the cases, the criteria is different. That's why I am telling you that there are two other cases. Okay, in this case also, it will further be two other cases. In this case also, there are further two other cases. Okay, so do you understand, my friend? Do you understand? All right, my friend. So let's get into the design process. Okay, let's get into the design process. One by one, we will consider all the different cases and we will design the machine element subjected to fluctuating load. Okay, all right, my friend. So the first process, the first problem that we will consider, the first problem that we will consider will be, the first problem that we will consider will be design of machine element against completely reversed stress for infinite life. Okay, how many cycles do we need? Infinite cycles. So we are going to design the machine element subjected to completely reverse stress for how many cycles? 10 to the power 6 cycle for infinite life, my friend. Okay, so design of machine element against completely reverse stress for infinite life. First of all, what is completely reverse stress? This is completely reverse stress. Minus sigma to plus sigma. Okay. Minus sigma maximum to plus sigma maximum. This is your completely reverse stress. In this case, we know that sigma m will be equal to 0. Okay. Sigma m will be equal to 0. And what will be sigma a? What will be sigma a, my friend? This is sigma a above the average. How much it is going, right? Above the mean, how much it is going? So it is going by this much, means sigma maximum. Sigma a will be sigma maximum. Okay. So in this case, what will be the criteria for infinite life? For infinite life means n greater than or equal to 10 to the power 6 cycles. N means number of cycles. So for infinite life, what will be the criteria, my friend? I told you that if the stresses are less than endurance strength, then you will get infinite life. If the stresses are more than endurance strength, you get finite life, right? What is the definition of endurance strength? Maximum plus minus sigma that you can apply for infinite cycles. If endurance strength is 200 megapascal, means less than 200 megapascal, if you apply, you will get infinite cycles. If let's say endurance strength is 200 megapascal, then if you apply less than 200 megapascal, you will get infinite cycles. So what will be the criteria here for infinite life? Your sigma maximum, whatever your sigma maximum should be less than endurance strength. If your sigma maximum is less than endurance strength, you will always get infinite life. If it becomes greater than endurance strength, then the life becomes finite. Okay, finite means less than 10 to the power 6. Okay, infinite means greater than or equal to 10 to the power 6. So for infinite life, your stress should always be less than endurance strength. But how much less? Less means how much less? That is decided by factor of safety. We have already seen it in theories of failure. I told you, less means how much less? That is decided by factor of safety. Okay, whether it should be half, whether it should be one third, whether it should be one fourth, that is decided by factor of safety. So sigma maximum should be equal to SE by factor of safety. Note this down. This is a very simple equation. Very simple equation. In case of completely reverse stress for infinite life, we are designing the component for infinite life, my friend. Okay. So this is the equation. Sigma maximum equals to SE by FOS. Note this down. And we will solve problems using this relation. Okay. Now, my friend, you must be wondering, sigma is normal stress, right? Sigma is normal stress. What about shear stress, my friend? So, in case of shear stress, your equation will become tau max equals to, in case of shear stress, This is normal stress, sigma. In case of shear stress, your equation will be tau max equals to SSE by FOS. Now, what is SSE, my friend? What is SSE? See, SE, this is the endurance strength. This is the endurance strength under bending, right? In the last lecture, I told you how the endurance strength is determined. Do you remember this? Do you remember this? Do you remember this? There is a specimen. There is a specimen. It is rotated. There is a specimen. It is rotated. And we apply a bending load, right? This is how we calculate endurance strength. This is known as rotating beam experiment. Do you remember? How do we find the endurance strength of material? Which testing do we perform? Rotating beam testing, right? So here, which load are we applying? Bending. Okay. Here the stresses are bending. So whatever strength you are calculating, that strength is under bending. Okay. But here we are applying shear stress. So here we need endurance strength under shear. This is endurance strength. Endurance strength under shear. Endurance strength under shear. And what will be the value, my friend? What will be the value? It is equal to 0.5 times of SE according to which theory, my friend? Maximum shear stress theory. And 0.577 times of SE according to maximum distortion energy theory. Do you remember the relation between tensile strength and shear strength? We derived 5 different relations for 5 different theories of failure. And I told you, usually we use 2 theories, right? One Mises theory, according to which shear strength will be 0.577 times of tensile strength. And shear stress theory, according to which shear strength will be half of tensile strength. Okay. So these are the 2 relations. This is according to maximum shear stress theory. And this is according to one Mises theory. So if let's say there is shear stress, then here the strength will be under shear. This is the strength under bending. Okay. Under normal stress, under sigma. And this is the strength under tau. So if you apply tau, what will be the strength? Either half of this strength or 0.577 times of this strength. Okay. But you don't have to decide which one you have to apply. Don't be afraid. Don't be confused. You don't have to decide. If there is a problem based on tau, then in the question, it will be mentioned. Either they will directly give you this value, either they will directly give you this value, or they will mention which relation you have to use, whether you have to use this relation or this relation. They will mention in the question. So you don't have to worry about that. Okay, don't worry about that. What relation you have to use, whether to use this relation or this relation, that we don't have to decide. This I am only telling you for your knowledge. Okay. But in the numericals, they will either mention this value directly or they will tell you which relation to use. So you will not have to judge. You will not have to decide which relation you have to use. Do you understand this? So in case of completely reverse stress for infinite life, these are the relation. Very simple relation, my friend, in order to design the machine element. Hit the like button if you like this video. If you like this, hit the like button right now. And then we will solve a problem, my friend. We will solve a problem so that you will understand how to use this, how to use this relation. What will be the practical application of this relation? Let's see that. Let's see that. Okay. So let's solve a few problems based on this case. Okay. Based on this case. What is the case? Completely reverse stress for infinite life. Completely reverse stress for infinite life. Okay. So this is our first case. So in this case, how you can design the machine element? Let's see that. Okay. So we will consider a problem and we will find the dimension of the body. Ultimately design means what? Ultimately design mean what? Design means finding the dimension. Okay. Ultimately we need to find some dimension. Okay. So let's find the dimension of the body. Okay. So let's say this is the question. Okay. Let's say this is the question. We have a rectangular plate. Okay. Let's say we have a rectangular plate subjected to axial load. We have a rectangular plate subjected to axial load, my friend. Okay. We have a rectangular plate subjected to axial load, and the axial load is plus minus 50 kilonewton. Let's say it is 50 kilonewton, my friend. Okay. Let's say this dimension is given. This dimension is given. Let's say this dimension is 80 mm. Okay. And this thickness is unknown. Thickness is unknown. This you don't have. And you have to calculate this. You have to find the thickness. Okay. Height you know. This is the cross section. This is the cross section. You know the height of cross section. You need to find the thickness of the cross section. Okay. And you have the corrected endurance strength. Corrected endurance strength means actual endurance strength. Last time we discussed this. Endurance strength depends upon lot of factor. Okay. This value is directly calculated from the test. But the actual value is different than this. It depends upon lot of factors. Surface finish, size, reliability, stress concentration. Okay. So either they will give you all these factors. Either in the question, they will give you all these factors, or they will directly give you this value. What is this value? Corrected or actual endurance strength. Corrected or actual endurance strength. Okay. What is this value, my friend? What is this value? Endurance strength from testing. Okay. This is calculated from testing. But this is the actual value. Okay. Which will depend upon what is the size of the body. What is the surface finish of the body. What is the reliability you need. And what is stress concentration. Okay. So, either they will give you all these factors. Or they will directly give you corrected endurance strength. So, let's say we have directly corrected endurance strength. Let's say the corrected endurance strength is 150 megapascal. Let's say corrected endurance strength is 150 megapascal. And let's say factor of safety is 2. Okay. Find out the thickness. Find out the thickness, my friend. Find out the thickness. This is the problem. You need to find the thickness. Okay. So, let's look at this. The load is plus minus 50. So, sigma will also be plus minus sigma. The stress will also be plus minus. Load is plus minus. So, stress will also be plus minus sigma. So, this is a completely reverse stress. This is a case of completely reverse stress. Okay. And nothing is mentioned. Are they giving any number of cycle? Is number of cycle mentioned in the question? No. So, if nothing is mentioned, you have to assume infinite life. If nothing is mentioned, if they are not mentioning number of cycle, if they are not given that you have to find thickness for this much cycle, if they are not giving that, then you have to assume that the problem is for infinite, the design is for infinite life. You need to find the thickness so that the plate will sustain infinite life. Okay, you have to save this plate for infinite life. If it is a problem of finite life, then they will mention number of cycle. They will give you number of cycle, 50,000 cycle. So you will have to only survive, save this. You have to save this plate only for 50,000 cycle. Okay. But they are not mentioning number of cycle means infinite life. Do you understand this point? Note this point. If nothing is mentioned, if number of cycles is not mentioned, that means you have to design it for infinite life. Now, what is the design equation, my friend? What is the design equation? This is the design equation. Sigma maximum should be equal to SE by FOS. This SE should be the corrected endurance strength. If they are giving some factor, then use that factor and find the corrected endurance strength. Okay. So, they are not giving any factor. They are directly giving the corrected endurance strength. Okay. So, what will be sigma maximum, my friend? Force upon area. This is axial load. So, the stress will be force upon area. So, it will be 50 kilonewton divided by, what will be the area, my friend? What will be this cross sectional area? Height into thickness. 80 into T. Okay, so this will be sigma maximum, right? This will be sigma maximum. Force upon area. What is the corrected endurance strength? 150 megapascal. This is the corrected endurance strength, 150 megapascal. And what is the factor of safety? 2. Factor of safety is 2. So this is a very simple design equation, my friend. And from here, you will get the value of thickness. So calculate what will be thickness. Calculate what will be thickness. From this, calculate what will be the required thickness. So the required thickness is 8.33 mm. So if your thickness is equal to 8.33 mm, then this plate will survive infinite life. For infinite cycles, nothing will happen to this plate. But if your thickness is less than 8.33 mm, then what will happen? Let's say the thickness is 6 mm. Then what will happen, my friend? It will survive, but only a few number of cycles. It will not survive infinite cycles. It will survive a few number of cycles, my friend. Okay. So for infinite cycles, this much thickness you should, be there for the plate. Okay. The plate should have minimum 8.33 mm thickness for infinite life. Okay. For infinite life. Do you understand this question? Do you understand this question? Very good, my friend. Let me give you another example. This time I will give you the example of shear. Okay. This time we will solve a problem related to shear, my friend. Okay. So solve this problem. Let's say we have a circular shaft. Okay. Let's say we have a circular shaft subjected to torque. Pure torque. No other load. Pure torque. Okay. Let's say we have a circular shaft subjected to pure torque. And what is the torque, my friend? The torque is fluctuating from plus 5 kilonewton meter to minus 5 kilonewton meter. Okay, plus minus 5 kilonewton meter. So this is also completely reverse stress. What is the torque fluctuation? Minus 5 to plus 5 kilonewton meter. So this is another case of completely reverse stress. Okay, you need to find diameter of shaft. Okay. Shear endurance strength is given. Shear endurance strength. What is shear endurance strength, my friend? SSE. Shear endurance strength means SSE. So under shear, they are directly giving endurance strength. You don't have to use the relation 0.5 times, 0.577 times. You don't have to use that. They are directly given. They are directly giving shear endurance strength. So what is the value of shear endurance strength, my friend? 180 megapascal. And factor of safety is also given 2. Factor of safety is also given 2. So this is the load, this is the strength. You need to find the diameter. So find the diameter, my friend. Find the diameter. Use the relation, use the design equation, and find the diameter. Very simple relation. You can directly find the diameter of the shaft. Find the diameter of the shaft. Design this shaft. Quickly, my friend, quickly design this shaft. This is a very simple problem. One mark problem. This is a very simple problem. So what will be the design equation? Tau max equals to SSE divided by FOS. This will be the design equation. SSE divided by FOS. What will be tau maximum? 16T by pi d cube. This will be tau maximum equals to SSE by FOS. This is the tau maximum, right? This is the equation of tau maximum in strength of material we have seen. What is the tau maximum under torque? 16T by pi d cube. Now my friend, put the value of torque. What is the value of torque? 5 kilonewton meter. Convert it into Newton mm. You have to convert kilonewton meter into Newton mm. So 5 into 10 to the power 6 divided by pi d cube should be equal to shear endurance strength. What is shear endurance strength? 180 megapascal divided by factor of safety 2. So this is the design equation, and by solving this equation you can find the diameter, required diameter of shaft for infinite life. In this question also, number of cycles are not mentioned. So you will design it for infinite life. Number of cycles are not mentioned means infinite life, my friend. If number of cycles are mentioned, then it is finite life. Not mentioned, infinite life. So what will be the diameter, my friend? What will be the diameter? Tell me what will be the diameter. Solve this equation and tell me what will be the diameter. Tell me what will be the diameter. So the diameter is 65.65 mm. This is the required diameter of the shaft. For how much cycles? Infinite cycles. If the diameter is less than this, then the cycles will become finite. The cycles will become less than 10 to the power 6 means finite cycles. So do you understand? Do you understand? Design of machine element subjected to completely reverse stress for infinite life. Do you understand this? Very good, my friend. Now, my friend, this was the first case of the problem. Okay, this was the first type of problem. Completely reverse stress for infinite life. Now we will see the second type of problem, my friend. Now we will see the second type of problem. What will be the second type of problem? It will be designed against completely reverse stress. The load will be completely reversed, but this time we will design it for finite life. This time the design will be for finite life. This time we don't need infinite life. This time we need finite life. For some number of cycles we have to design. Okay, for some number of cycle, it can be 10,000 cycle, 20,000, 50,000, 70,000, but for some number of cycle, for limited number of cycle, we have to design. Okay, so this time the load is same, but we don't need infinite life, we need finite life. So let's see what will be the design process in this case. So the load is same, the load is same, the load is same, minus sigma maximum 2 plus sigma maximum. Load is same. Okay, load is same. Here also sigma m is 0, load is same, but this time the life is finite. Now, my friend, first of all, you need to understand a concept of fatigue strength, a concept of fatigue strength, which is denoted by SF. Endurance strength is SE, fatigue strength is SF. So let's understand what is fatigue strength. Okay, and I will explain this concept using this graph, stress versus number of cycle. Okay, so for infinite life, what should be the stress? SE. For infinite life, what should be the stress? SE. But let's say you don't need infinite life. Infinite life means 10 to the power 6 cycles. Let's say I don't need 10 to the power 6 cycles. Let's say I only need 10 to the power 4 cycles. Okay, let's say I don't need 10 to the power 6 cycles. I only need 10 to the power 4 cycles. Then what should be the stress? That stress is known as fatigue strength. What is this, my friend? Fatigue strength. Fatigue strength. What is this, my friend? Endurance strength. Endurance strength. And what is this? Fatigue strength. So what is the difference between endurance strength and fatigue strength? Endurance strength means what should be the stress for infinite life. Endurance strength means what should be the stress for infinite life. Fatigue strength means what should be the stress for some number of cycle. For some number of cycle, let's say 10 to the power 4 cycle. So for 10 to the power 4 cycle, there will be some maximum stress. For 10 to the power 4, if you need 10 to the power 4 cycle, if you want your machine element to survive 10 to the power 4 cycle, there will be some maximum value of stress which you should not cross. So that maximum stress which you should not cross is fatigue strength. Endurance strength is the stress which you should not cross for infinite life. But if you want finite life, if you want only some number of cycle, then which stress you should not cross? You should not cross fatigue strength. Do you understand this? Endurance strength means maximum stress for infinite life. Fatigue strength means maximum stress for finite life. Finite life means some number of cycle. For 10 to the power 4 cycle, there will be some fluctuating strength. Okay. For 10 to the power 4 cycle, there will be some fatigue strength. For 10 to the power 3 cycle also, there will be some fatigue strength. This fatigue strength and this fatigue strength will be different. This is also known as fatigue strength. This is also known as fatigue strength. Both are different. This is the fatigue strength for 10 to the power 3 cycle. This is the fatigue strength for 10 to the power 3 cycle. This is the fatigue strength for 10 to the power 4 cycle. So for every number of cycle, there is a fatigue strength. But endurance strength means infinite cycle. Endurance strength means infinite cycle. So do you understand my point, what I am trying to explain? Do you understand my point, what I am trying to explain? Do you understand my point? So we don't need infinite life. We need only finite life, my friend. We need only finite life. Okay. Now, my friend, let's say fatigue strength. Let's say fatigue strength SF for n number of cycles. Fatigue strength SF for n number of cycles is equal. Fatigue strength for n number of cycles is equal to SF. Okay. Fatigue strength for n number of cycle is SF. Okay. Let's say 50,000 cycle. So for 50,000 cycle, let's say fatigue strength is SF. So what will be your criteria now? Maximum how much you can apply for n number of cycle, maximum how much you can apply? SF. Okay. But will you apply SF? No. Your sigma maximum should be less than SF. Okay. This is the maximum you can apply. This is the maximum you can apply for n number of cycle. This is the maximum you can apply, but you will not cross this. So your sigma max should be less than SF. For infinite life, sigma max should be less than SE. But for n number of cycle, for finite life, sigma max should be less than SF. Or you can write sigma max should be equal to SF by FOS. Sigma max will be equal to SF by FOS. So the equation is same. The only difference is this time sigma max should not be less than SE. It should be less than SF, my friend. This time it will be less than SF. What is SF? Fatigue strength for n number of cycles. Some number of cycle will be given. 10,000 cycle, 20,000 cycle, 50,000 cycle. That cycle will be given. So first you have to find SF and then you have to use this relation. SE is directly given, but SF you need to find. SF you need to find. Okay. So to use this equation, first we need to find SF. How will you find SF? How will you find SF? That is the problem. How will you find SF? How will you find fatigue strength? How will you find fatigue strength? How to find fatigue strength? How to find SF? Okay, let's see that. How to find SF? Let's see that. So in order to find SF, we plot a curve between stress and number of cycles. Okay, we plot a curve between stress and number of cycles. This curve is known as SN curve. Okay, it is a curve between stress and number of cycles and it is known as SN curve. And why we are drawing it? To find SF. Fatigue strength. If you want to design it for finite life, first you need to find SF and then you will put it in the equation. Okay. So how will we find the SF? Using the SN curve. So this will be the SN curve. This will be the SN curve. Okay. This will be the SN curve. On x-axis, this is the x-axis, we plot log n base 10. Log n means log of number of cycles and this log is not natural log. It is log base 10. And for y-axis, we plot log s base 10. S means stress. Okay. So this is the number of cycle and this is the stress. And look at this. It is a logarithmic cycle. So whatever value you will get here, it will be log base 10. it will be log base 10. Okay, so my friend, this curve will be drawn from 10 to the power 3 cycles to 10 to the power 6 cycles. This is log base 10, 10 to the power 3, which will be equal to 3, and this will be log base 10, 10 to the power 6, which will be equal to 6. So 10 to the power 3 cycles, 10 to the power 6 cycles. So this curve is drawn from 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 6 cycle. It will be like a straight line. Okay, it will be a straight line. This curve is particularly for steel. Okay, this curve is particularly for steel. Whatever we are understanding, it is for steel. After 10 to the power 6 cycle, what happens to the curve? It becomes horizontal. After 10 to the power 6, it will become horizontal. We don't need this curve in that case. If you want more than 10 to the power 6, then you don't need this curve. Then you know what will be the stress. Se. We want this curve for finite life. We want this curve for finite life. Less than 10 to the power 6. Okay. Now my friend, on this y axis or x axis, we have these two values. On y axis, what will be the value, my friend? On y axis, what will be the value? For 10 to the power 6 cycles, what will be the stress? For 10 to the power 6 cycles, for steel, what will be the stress? Log 10 Se. And for 10 to the power 3 cycles, what will be the stress? Log of 0.9 SUT or 0.8 SUT. It is between 0.8 SUT. SUT means ultimate strength. Okay. So, corresponding to 10 to the power 3 cycles, what should be the stress? For steel. For steel, this value is 0.9 SUT or it is also 0.8 SUT. Some cases, it can also be 0.8 SUT. It varies from 0.8 to 0.9. Okay. This is just an approximate value. This is not an exact value. It is an approximate value. Okay. It is an approximate value. So, at 10 to the power 3 cycle, what is the strength? 0.9 SUT. At 10 to the power 6 cycle, what is the strength? Log of Se. What do we need? We need strength at n number of cycle. We need strength at n number of cycle. Okay. So, from this curve, we will find what will be the strength at n number of cycle, my friend. Okay. Now, my friend, in order to find the fatigue strength for n number of cycle, we need to first find the equation of this line. We need to find the equation of this line. Let's say this point is 0.1 and this point is 0.2. So, what is the equation of line? What is the equation of line? What will be the equation of SN curve? Tell me, what is the equation of line? Y minus Y1 by Y2 minus Y1 equals to X minus X1 by X2 minus X1, right? Now, my friend, what is Y1? What is Y1? This is the first point. So, Y1 is this log of 0.9 SUT. Log of 0.9 SUT. Which log? Log base 10. Remember, it is log base 10, not log base E. It is not natural log. It is log base 10. Okay. So, log of 0.9 SUT. This is Y1 divided by Y2. This is the second point. So, Y2 log of SE minus log of 0.9 SUT equals to X minus X1. X minus X1. So, which one is 1? This point is 1. So, this is X1, 3. This is 3. See, my friend, this is log of 10 to the power 3. So, log of 10 to the power 3 means 3. Log of 10 to the power 6 means 6. This is 10 to the power 3 cycles. This is 10 to the power 6 cycles. Okay. Divided by X2 minus X1. This is the equation of your SN curve. From this equation, you can find the fatigue strength. How will you find fatigue strength from this relation? Let's say you need to find fatigue strength for n number of cycle. Okay, you need to find fatigue strength for n number of cycle. Okay, so let's say for n number of cycle, fatigue strength is SF. For n number of cycle, fatigue strength is SF. Okay. So now put the value of x here. It will be log of n. And put the value of y here. It will be log of SF. Now, my friend, if you know the value of n, you can find the value of SF. If you know the value of n, you can find the value of SF. If I give you value of n, 10 to the power 4, 10 to the power 5, whatever, then you can find the value of SF, my friend. Okay. So this is the equation. This is the equation of SN curve, which you use to find fatigue strength. And once you find fatigue strength, then you can easily use this relation. Sigma max should be equal to SF by FOS. Okay. Sigma max should be equal to SF by FOS. So we need, in order to use this relation, we need SF. And in order to find SF, we are using this SN curve. Do you understand this process, my friend? Do you understand this process? This is for finite life. If the number of cycles are given, 10 to the power 3 cycle, 4 cycle, some cycles, number of cycles, then first what you will do, you will plot this SN curve and you will find SF. For n number of cycle, you will find SF. Once you get SF, then you can calculate the dimensions of the body using this relation. Do you understand this? So SN curve is plotted to find the fatigue strength for any number of cycle between 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 6, my friend. After 10 to the power 6, we don't need this curve. Why? Because after 10 to the power 6, it will become horizontal, it will become infinite. So what will be the criteria? You don't need SF. What will you put here? After 10 to the power 6 cycle, you will put SE. Simply, you will put SE. Now, my friend, you must be wondering, what will happen before 10 to the power 3? This curve is from 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 6. So what about before 10 to the power 3? Why don't we draw this before 10 to the power 3? So my friend, if the number of cycle are less than 10 to the power 3, then it is known as low cycle fatigue. It is known as low cycle fatigue. If the number of cycle are greater than 10 to the power 3, then it is known as high cycle fatigue. Okay. What is low cycle fatigue? Number of cycles are less than 10 to the power 3. 10 to the power 3 means 1000. So number of cycles are less than 1000. Only 100 cycles. Let's say the load is fluctuating, but only for 100 cycles, then it is known as low cycle fatigue. And if the number of cycles are greater than 10 to the power 3, then it is known as high cycle fatigue. In our syllabus, we only discuss high cycle fatigue. Low cycle fatigue is not in our syllabus. The concept of low cycle fatigue are completely different, my friend. But we will not get into those concepts because this is out of our syllabus. This is not in our syllabus. Okay. Before 10 to the power 3, what you need to do, that is not in our syllabus. So forget about that. So do you understand why I am drawing the curve only between 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 6? Because before 10 to the power 3, this cycle is known as low cycle fatigue, and the concept related to this is completely different, my friend. Okay. So we don't have to discuss those concepts. We don't have to discuss those concepts. Okay. All right, my friend. So this is the process to design machine element for n number of cycle, completely reverse stress and n number of cycle. Now, my friend, this curve, SN curve, is very important because you will find previous year question based on SN curve. You will find previous year question based on SN curve. So this is a very important curve. Okay. You will find numericals based on this. So let's solve those numericals. Let's directly solve numericals from previous year question. Okay. Let's solve problems of previous year gate. So this is a very interesting problem. This is a very interesting problem. Question number 20. This is a very interesting problem. Question number 20, my friend. Sorry. You don't know what is question number 20. This is a problem from gate 2017. This is a problem from gate 2017. Let's discuss this problem. Okay. Let's discuss this problem. So a machine element has ultimate strength of 600 megapascal. A machine element has ultimate strength of 600 megapascal. Ultimate strength is given 600 megapascal and endurance strength is given. Endurance strength is given 250 megapascal. And ultimate strength is 600. Endurance strength is 250. It is need to be designed for 10,000 cycles. It needs to be designed for 10,000 cycles. So N is given 10,000 cycles. Okay. And the curve is given. The SN curve is given. The SN curve is given. The SN curve is given. And what do you need to find? You need to find the maximum completely reversed stress that you can apply. Means you need to find the fatigue strength for N number of cycle. You need to find fatigue strength for N number of cycle. This is given, my friend. This curve is given. This curve is given. Okay. This curve is given. This curve is given. This is for 10 to the power 6 cycles. This is 10 to the power 3 cycles. Okay. This is 10 to the power 3 cycle. It is given like this. This is log of SE. And this is log of 0.8 SUT. I told you, it is not always 0.9 SUT. It varies from 0.8 to 0.9 because it is not an exact value. You can use 0.8 to 0.9. Okay. All right. So this is the question, my friend. This is the question. Now, first of all, what you have to do, find the equation of this straight line. Find the equation of this straight line. Let's consider this point 1 and this is point 2. So draw the equation. Draw the equation. Find the equation. Find the equation of this SN curve. And then on that equation, put the value of N and find the fatigue strength. Okay. So write down the equation of this SN curve. So what will be the equation of fatigue strength, my friend? What will be the equation? See, y minus y1. So what will be y1, my friend? What will be y1? This will be y1. Log of 0.8 SUT. What is SUT? 600. 600. Divided by y2 minus y1. So what is y2? Log of SE. What is SE? 250. So it will be log of 250 minus y1. What is y1? Log of 0.8 into 600. Okay. So y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equals to x minus x1. So what will be x1, my friend? Log of 10 to the power 3 means 3. And log of 10 to the power 6 means 6. So divided by 6 minus 3. So now, my friend, this is the equation. This is the equation of the SN curve. Now, on this equation, you need to find SF. Number of cycle is given. What is number of cycle? 10 to the power 4. 10 to the power 4. And you need to find SF. Okay. So this will be SF. This will be SF and this will be 4. Log of 10 to the power 4 means 4. So this is your equation. Just solve this equation and you will get the value of log of SF. Okay. So solve this equation and tell me what is the value of log of SF. Tell me what is the value of log of SF. Okay. Tell me what is the value of log of SF. Solve this and find the value of log of SF. Tell me the value of log of SF, my friend. Log of SF. What is log of SF? Solve this and find log of SF. Find the value of log of SF. So the log of SF is 2.5868. If you solve this, you will get this. 2.5868. Solve this equation in your calculator. Put the values in your calculator and solve it. You should get 2.5868. Log of SF equals to 2.5868. Are you getting this? Are you getting this? Now, my friend, we need to find SF. So what we will do? We will take the NT log. So how will we take the NT log? SF will be equal to 10 to the power 2.5868. SF will be equal to 10^2.5868. So what will be the value of SF, my friend? What will be the value of SF? 10^2.5868 means what will be the value of SF? SF will be equal to, my friend, what will be the value of SF? SF will be equal to 386.2 megapascal. SF will be equal to 386.2 megapascal. 386.2 megapascal. So this is the value of SF, my friend. This is the value of SF. 386.2 megapascal. So do you understand this? Do you understand this? This is a problem of GATE 2017. This is a problem of GATE 2017, my friend. I have shared a PDF of previous year GATE solved question. Okay, previous year solved questions of GATE in our Telegram channel. So don't forget to follow our Telegram channel. You will find all the PDF notes, previous year question booklet, problems to solve, everything on our Telegram channel only. Okay, you will get the study material related to all our lectures on our Telegram channel. So go to our Telegram channel. It is, the link is in the description. The link is given in the description. Go to that channel and download the previous year GATE question and solve the problems from previous year GATE question. Solve the problems of previous year GATE question and your machine design will be completed. If you can solve the problems of previous year GATE, then your machine design is over. Okay. So this is a problem from GATE 2017. Okay. I will give you another question from GATE. In this problem, number of cycles were given and you had to calculate fatigue strength. Now we will see another problem where you have to calculate number of cycles. We will see another problem where you have to calculate number of cycles, my friend. Okay. I will give you a problem where you have to calculate number of cycles. Okay. So solve this problem. Solve this problem. Solve this problem, my friend. This problem is from GATE 2006. This problem is from GATE 2006. I will write down the problem for you. I will write down the problem for you. A cylindrical shaft. A cylindrical shaft. A cylindrical shaft is subjected to a cylindrical shaft. Is subjected to alternating stress. Alternating stress means completely reverse stress. Okay, same thing. Alternating stress means completely reverse stress. So a cylindrical shaft is subjected to alternating stress of 100 megapascal. Alternating stress of 100 megapascal. Fatigue strength. Fatigue strength to sustain. Fatigue strength to sustain 1000 cycles is 490 megapascal. Fatigue strength to sustain 1000 cycles is 490 megapascal. If corrected endurance strength, if corrected endurance strength, if corrected endurance strength is 70 megapascal, if corrected endurance strength is 70 megapascal, find the life of shaft in number of cycles. You need to find the life of shaft in number of cycles, my friend. Okay, you need to find the life of shaft in number of cycles. Okay, so find the life of shaft in number of cycles. Find the life of shaft in number of cycle, my friend. Okay, I want you to find the life of shaft in number of cycles. Okay, so in this question, stress is given 100 megapascal. Okay, stress is given and you need to find number of cycle. If I apply this much stress, what will be the number of cycle? In the last question, we had number of cycle and we were calculating how much stress we can apply. In this question, stress is given. And we need to find how much cycles we will get. If you apply 100 megapascal, how much cycle we will get. Okay. Now, my friend, first of all, plot the SN curve. Draw the SN curve, my friend. Okay. It will help you to write the equation. It will help you to write the equation. Draw the SN curve. Draw the SN curve. What is the value? Endurance strength is 70 megapascal. SE is 70 megapascal. Now, here, my friend, You don't have to use the relation 0.9 SUT or 0.8 SUT. Here for 1000 cycles, the strength is directly given. For 1000 cycle means for 10 to the power 3 cycle, what is the strength? 490 megapascal. Okay, so endurance strength 70, 10 to the power 6. At 10 to the power 6, the strength is 70. At 10 to the power 3, the strength is 490. And the stress is given 100. You need to find number of cycle. So let's first draw the SN curve. Let's draw the SN curve. From the SN curve, it will be very easy to write down the equation. Okay? Now, my friend, this is 3 cycles. 10 to the power 3 cycle means 3. This is 10 to the power 6 cycles means 6. For 10 to the power 6 cycles, what is the value given? SE. What is SE? 70. Okay? And for 10 to the power 3 cycle, what is the value given? 490. Okay? So, this much is given. For 10 to the power 6 cycle, endurance strength is given 70. And for 10 to the power 3 cycle, this is given 490. Directly. Here, you don't have to put 0.8 SUT, 0.9 SUT. In the question, they are directly given 490 megapascal. Now, what they are asking, if I apply 100 megapascal, what will be number of cycles? So, in the last question, we put number of cycle and we calculated stress. Here, we have the stress, 100, but we need number of cycle. Same thing you need to do. Write down the equation. y minus y1. So what is your y? Log of 100. This is first point, this is second point. So y minus y1 equals to divided by y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1. What is your y2? Log of 70 divided by y1. Y2 minus y1 equals to x minus x1. This x is unknown. In this case, x is unknown. So, log of n minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay? So, this is your equation. Y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equals to x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. So, here we know the stress and we need to find number of cycles. So, solve this. You will get log of n. Solve this and find log of n. Solve this equation and tell me what is log of n. And from that, we can easily find n. If you have log of n, just take anti-log and you will get n. So, what is log of n, my friend? If you solve this, what is log of n? Tell me what will be log of n. Solve this equation. Using your calculator, solve this equation. All these are log base 10. Okay. So, find what is log of n. So, log of n will be equal to 5.4501. Log of n will be 5.4501. And then n will be equal to 10 to the power 5.4501. Taking anti-log, it will be 10 to the power 5.4501. So, it will be approximately equal to 2819 10 cycles. Approximately. Okay. Approximately, it will be equal to 2819 10 cycles. So, these are the number of cycles. If you apply 100 megapascal, you will get this much number of cycles. Do you understand this? Very good, my friend. If you have still not liked this video, you are not doing good to me, my friend. Please hit the like button, my friend. We have solved two types of problems today. Completely reverse stress for infinite life, completely reverse stress for finite life. Now, my friend, these were the first set of problems. These were the first case when sigma m is 0. Completely reverse stress means sigma m is 0. But what if sigma m is not 0? What if sigma m is not 0? Those type of problems are completely different and their design process is completely different. Okay. So in the next lecture, we will see if sigma m is not 0, then how to solve the problem. Here all the problems were related to completely reverse stress. All the problems were related to completely reverse stress where sigma m is 0. So we saw two types of problems, for infinite life, for finite life. But in both cases, the stress was completely reverse, means sigma m is 0. In the next lecture, we will see what to do if sigma m is not 0. Fluctuating stress, problem related to fluctuating stress. Okay. So in the next lecture, we will see the design process of fluctuating stress, my friend. Okay. So in the next lecture, we will complete the fluctuating load. We will complete this chapter, fluctuating load. We have already seen the first chapter, static load, theories of failure. In the next lecture, we will complete the second chapter and then we will start the next chapter, my friend. Okay. So this is for today's lecture. Don't forget to share this video with at least three of your friends. Share this video, my friend. Tell them about this video and tell them that every day from Monday to Saturday, every day there will be a class of machine design at 7:30 p.m. on this YouTube channel, Unacademy GateME. Share the link with them and ask them to be online. I will be here solving all your doubts, my friend. I will be in the live chat solving all your doubts. Okay. So please be online every day from Monday to Saturday. Sunday will be off. There will be no class on Sunday. From Monday to Saturday, we will be here at 7:30 p.m. learning the concepts of machine design. And you have to support me in order to grow our number of subscribers, in order to reach to maximum number of people. You have to support me. You have to share the link of this video. And don't forget to follow the Telegram channel. We will post all the relevant study material on our Telegram channel. Okay. And my friend, whatever I am explaining here, this is just a trailer. Okay. We don't get too much time on YouTube, my friend. So we have limited time on YouTube. So here, whatever I'm explaining to you, this is just a trailer. Why? If you think why we are spending less time on YouTube, spend more time on YouTube, teach us everything on YouTube. So my friend, YouTube is not for online lectures, my friend. This is not a platform of online lectures. There are a lot of things which you cannot do here. What you cannot do here? Let's say you are solving problems at your home and you find a question which is very difficult to solve. Can you send that question to me? Can you send that question to me here? No, you can't send that question to me here. Okay. So what you will do on Unacademy Plus? On Unacademy Plus, there are tools using which you can send your question directly to your educator, directly to your teacher, and then your teacher will solve the problem then and there in the live class. He will solve your question and he will tell you the solution. So there are a lot of things that you can't do on YouTube which is possible on Unacademy Plus. Why? Because Unacademy Plus is specially designed for online learning. YouTube is not designed for online learning. This is for entertainment. We can use it for learning purpose. But there are a lot of tools which are not possible here, which are not here. But on Unacademy Plus, you will feel like you are sitting in a classroom. Go and take some special classes. Special classes are free of cost. Okay. So download the Unacademy app and take some special classes free of cost. They are free of cost. So you can take special classes and you can see for yourself that the Unacademy Plus is completely different than YouTube. That's why we ask you to subscribe to Unacademy Plus. Okay. That's why we cannot solve the entire thing. We cannot cover the entire syllabus on YouTube, my friend. That's why we spend most of our time on Unacademy Plus, because Unacademy Plus is specially for teaching and learning, YouTube is for entertainment, which can be used for learning, but it is not especially designed for learning. Unacademy Plus, specially designed for learning, my friend. There are tools for educators and for learners. Okay, so be a learner or an Academy Plus. Every day a lot of students are joining, my friend. A lot of students are joining. Recently we have launched a batch for GATE and engineering services. We have launched a batch for SSC JEE also, and in the upcoming days we are going to launch a rank improvement batch, especially for GATE aspirants, those who are taking a drop or those who have already covered their syllabus but they need to improve their rank. Okay, they need to improve their knowledge, they need to solve a lot of problems. So in rank improvement batch we will solve a lot of problems, lot of numericals, my friend. The only objective there will be to solve as many numericals from every subject, as many numericals as possible. Okay, so we will be taking those classes, my friend. Me, my fellow educators will be taking those classes, my friend. So join Unacademy Plus as soon as possible. Use this code, use this code. Okay, use this code. This is my code, approved 10. You will get 10% discount. You will get 10% discount. It doesn't mean that if you are using this code, some people are thinking that if you use this code, you'll be only able to see my classes. Not necessary, my friend. You can take any classes. It is like Netflix. It is like Netflix. Unacademy Plus is like Netflix. If you take Netflix subscription, you can watch any movie, you can watch any TV series, right? So if you take Unacademy Plus subscription, you can watch any lecture. Okay, it doesn't mean that you will only watch me. You can watch any lecture, my friend. So take my coupon code, use this code to get 10% discount. Okay, and if you have any doubt, email me or Facebook me, text me on Facebook or Instagram. On Facebook and Instagram, I'm very easy to find. My name is Apurup Rao. My name is Apurup Rao. So just type my name, Apurup Rao, and you will find me on Facebook, you will find me on Instagram. Okay, this is a very unique name, so you'll have no difficulty finding me. And my email ID is this. You can also mail me. If you are not using Facebook or Instagram, you can mail me approve2008@gmail.com. If you have any doubt regarding your career, regarding your preparation, how to prepare, whether to take Unacademy Plus subscription or not, what to do. So if you have any doubts regarding that, contact me and I will try to solve your doubt. I will try to sort your things out. Okay, so please don't waste your time and join Unacademy Plus as soon as possible. A lot of students have already joined. Okay, so you will be behind them. If you waste your time, you will be behind them. Okay, you still have a time. You still have time. We have just launched the batch. You will not miss any lecture. There are recorded lectures also. You will not miss any lecture. So we have just launched the batch and we will launch a new batch. In the next month, we will launch a new batch. So join Unacademy Plus as soon as possible, my friend. As soon as possible. So this was all for today's lecture. Thank you very much for watching, my friends.